Well, hello there, humans, hippies, earthlings, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and if you're lucky enough indeed to be doing it too, today's video is all about tips, tricks, and little things that I like to do to get the chicken dinner, indeed to get across the line in that numero uno position. And if you want to do better and you want to find about a little inside edge that you can possibly turn into that chicken gold, then watch on and learn. To do this, I basically jumped a bunch of people into a training room with me. All the patrons, patreon.com/thebushco. Remember to subscribe, like the videos, and also hit that big notification, ding-a-ling-a-ling, bell. Because these kind of things, these kind of bits of info, like how far away you can hear things happening and such, will actually win you chicken dinners. There's no way around this. I use this all the time. To give you an example, this is what I like. Kill feed and circle put together equals radar. Now, you can see there's a marker on the mini-map to my southeast. Then next to me, the kill feed pops, and it says Kara Kasati, or whatever his name is, killed someone with an SKS. The circle is shutting down. I'm going to run along the edge of the circle, and I know that somewhere out here there is a single person that has wiped a couple of people out in the kill feed, so that this area contains one bad guy. And if I run along the edge of the circle, I am going to find this one bad guy either moving in through the blue, looting the people that he's just killed, or in front of my guns running down the hill. And if I can kill him, then the rest of that area of the circle belongs to me, and I only have to worry about what's in front of me. That's called watching the kill feed and knowing who's doing what. Voila, you killed Karakosi with M416. That whole area is clear. Okay, some of the things that you can hear. You can hear a grin being pulled from 22 meters away. Kind of crazy, hey? But there's a big difference here because you can hear different distances for different throwables. Smoke and frag grenades were both exactly the same, which was not really surprising. But a molly, you can hear a faint whoosh up to 33 meters away as you prime and light that bad boy up. Generally, you'll start hearing it clearer around 30 meters. But a molly is heard from further away than a frag grenade pin, which is kind of crazy. You can hear someone reloading a magazine from 15 meters away, which is not very far away at all, and actually really surprised me. Some other big ones that I found very important. You can hear a med kit being used 13 meters away. And all of these pills and med kits and such vary between that 13 to 15 meter range, depending on the quality of your headphones too. Footsteps are 20 meters on the mini-map. That's how far away they appear on the mini-map. We know all that. They actually pop at 48 meters when people are running, which is really, really interesting. That's how far you can hear them. Bandages is 15 meters away. You can hear someone bandaging 15 meters away, which is obviously very, very important. Same as med kits. Actually, it's slightly further away than med kits. You can hear it. At least that was with my testing. Same with pills and Red Bulls. That's 13 as well. They're all around about the same distance. Now, not everything in this video is going to be that dry and that boring, but I thought I'd get that stuff out of the way early on so that then we can move on to the juicy, nitty-gritty stuff. And here we go. Number one, stop tunneling like a noob. I find this just fascinating that so many people... This guy's camping a crate. He's got an 8x scope on a Mark 14, and he's so desperately camping the crate that we actually roll up and run him over. Like, that's nuts. This guy is engaging my mate, Mr. Ouija. He's pro-leaning through a window, and I'm able to, like, just waltz up a set of stairs. You've got to be able to do what you're doing, even in a heavy gunfight, and hear that vehicle coming in, like that boat, and pay attention to everything that's going on around you, whether or not you're, you're in a good, safe position or not. Because if you don't, then you're just going to end up getting wiped all the time by people. Stop peeking, Orms. I mean, I knocked that dude and his mate turns up. And I know his mate has an orm. I know his mate has an orm. There's seven left alive. I'm solo versus squad. I've done 2,000 and something damage. I'm on for a good game here. Don't peek an orm. An orm will one-shot headshot you and just really, really ruin your day. You've got to make a conscientious decision not to thirst when there is, in fact, a target. You can see there, I thirsted when Mr. Ouija was in trouble instead of going straight to him. That was a mistake. And then that guy thirsted Mr. Ouija, which was a big mistake from him on his part, because while he was doing that, I killed him. Watch this, man. I'm going to run into this room, balls to the wall, third partying. Oh. Oh. You thirsty grub. That's a target that is already down and out for the count. And I'm actually going to run out of ammunition here and need to reload and switch. And by that time... Don't thirst. It'll get you killed all the time. These are my two favorite beachheads on Erangel. The first is on the Mill Bay side, the south side, and it is just to the west of the furthest bridge, the furthest east bridge. And the reason I like this is it's basically got some cover in front of it. You can pull up straight away into a ridgeline. There is a small house there as well that you can get a look at. And it's just far enough away from the bridge that not much is going to render there. You've got a 300 meter render range in mobile. This is the northern side. I really like this area because, again, you pull up directly under a cliff. It's not a big open beach. It's so easy to get screwed on one of those beaches near farm and such. And then you climb up this little crevice in the rock here, just straight on up, turn left at the top, bang, 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 bang. It also gives you a great overview if you time it right where you can look back at people swimming across from Millbase Island, and they're really easy frags. So this one's an absolute gold mine. It's also a really great space to run into the zone from. You can skirt the edges of that cliff and go all kinds of all over the place. You should really give the Vector a go on Sanok. The Vector is a gun that is massively underutilized, and I've done a lot of videos with the Vector, and I actually use it a lot on Sanok. It's one of my very, very favorite alternate weapons. Sanok's great for broken cover, and it really requires, you know, close quarters gun work, and that is where the Vector excels. Incredible, incredible rate of fire, and it's really good on a switch too. If you've got a Vector on a switch, you can do all kinds of nasty things. This next one, I've got those clips back to front. Pro play. That's the Vector on the switch with the barrel. Yeah, we'll leave that in. Sometimes you need to let your teammate die. This is the last one I want to talk about. And this is Swiss Cheezel. And Swiss is saying, dude, just go and kill them. Go and kill these dudes. Like, you're going to get me up and, you know, we're going to get screwed here. That's the second time he got knocked that he was saying that. Anyway, I get Swiss up, right? And I'm going to go out to the right flank here and knock a guy. And that is the perfect time to clear the squad, okay? There's a knocked dude here. Once he's down, I get another guy knocked. And Swiss gets knocked again. It's like, oh, I should really push this. No, I'll come back and get him. I'll come back and get him again. That's two knocks right there. That's two knocks. I could have won the game right there. And Swiss is like, dude, just go and finish me. Like, no, I'll get you up. You're my bro. You're my friend, my pal. I'm not going to let you down. And I end up just reviving my buddy three times, or rather two times. And then the last time he's like, dude, just go and kill them. And crawls into the blue zone and eats all the damage. He's like, get out of here. Go and kill them. And we ended up dying. And it wasn't Swiss's fault. He got knocked. But he absolutely was right. The second time there, I should have left Swiss alone. That was a 1v1 situation. I couldn't have asked for a better opportunity to win a chicken dinner. If you started every plane trip and you just had to go one-on-one to win it, that's a pretty juicy prospect. Anyway, I hope you like those tips. I hope you like those tricks. Until next time, look after yourselves and stay safe on the battlefield. Bye for now. Ow. Oh, hurts to watch.